My name's Kimberly Insigne, and we're at University of California, Los Angeles, in Dr. Kosuri's lab. And I'm a first-year bioinformatics graduate student. I'm one of the few people who does bioinformatics, which essentially means, fancy way to say, a mix of biology and computer science. So if you think about the way humans work, you can kind of think of it as a genetic code, how there's a code that describes how our body works, how it regulates itself, but a lot of the times we don't know how all of that works together. So what I do is I bring computer science into the mix. That's what my field is all about, is using computer science to try and understand the genetic code. What I'm doing in Dr. Kosuri's lab, the project I'm going to be starting, is taking that idea of understanding the genetic code, but taking it to a more simple level of understanding how it works in bacteria. There's a huge field of synthetic biology. We use E. coli to make a lot of stuff. We make, for example, insulin is made in E. coli. So the idea is, if you understand how something works really well, you can make things more efficiently, you can fine tune them. So that's what my project is in this lab, is working on understanding how genes work in E. coli. I grew up technically in Temecula, California, which is about an hour north of San Diego. It's known for its vineyards and everything. So I grew up in Southern California, and I went to school at UCSD and came here for UCLA. So I was born and raised in Southern California, probably never gonna leave. I've always kind of been medically inclined, I guess, since I was young. My dad's a doctor in the Navy, and my mom works in a health sciences company. I'm a scientist because coming into undergrad, I thought I wanted to be a doctor because I want to, you know, obviously help out people, but the more and more I thought about it, the more I realized that that's not where I wanted to focus in my efforts. I of course want to help out people, but I think where the most important lies is, you know, the research. Being able to solve a problem, not just for one person, but for everyone. And I think that's really important. Like, people need to be working in science, because I don't think people understand that. People think science is all about going in and solving one big problem and then you're done, but that's not what it's about. It's about going in and solving a very small problem that will probably take you a long time, but it's so worth it, just knowing that you contributed to that body of knowledge and that the things you're doing are helping everyone, humankind in general, not just one person at a time. My mission in the lab is to understand how genes are regulated in E. coli. So the way I do that, it's kind of unique aspect, which I really love, is that I'm equally good at, you know, experiments and wet lab work, but I'm also really good at programming. So a lot of the things I can do is, if I want to, say, test a hypothesis in E. coli, say I want to change slightly how a gene works and see how it does, but from a computer programming perspective, I can write all the code necessary to make all the changes I want, and then hop on over to the bench and test everything out. So for me, it's really fun being able to go back and forth between the two things. It's so much fun every day coming in. I come in and, you know, usually, you know, the first couple is just catching up with everyone, and as everyone's just going in and out of lab, I'm talking to people, I'm constantly asking people questions. I go to seminars during the day and I see a lot of other people in the field that I talk to, and I would definitely say I'm not alone in the lab. The hopes and dreams of my research are that we can understand our own DNA, how we work, so well that we can kind of take control of it. I see it as, you know, having your DNA looked at when you go to the doctor is routine. You go in, when you're young, you see your DNA, you have this amount of risk for getting Alzheimer's, for being obese, for having diabetes, and being able to kind of track that throughout your life and be able to have more personalized preventative medicine. And that's what I really hope for, and that's why I do what I do, because I think we can get to that place where we can understand ourselves so well that we can kind of control our health at a level that we can't even imagine right now. I would say to anyone thinking about this career that I feel like anybody could do it. There's so many different areas in science. If you think you're really good at math, you can be more biostatistics. If you don't, like, there's so many different fields, and I feel like attracts very many different personalities, people who are independent, people who want to collaborate a lot, people who, and especially for those who want to kind of have control over what they do with their career, because a lot of science is being able to ask those big questions and having the resources to do it and having the support to do it. So it's really a really open-ended field. It's kind of, you know, if you can think it, you can do it in science, and that's not even a cliche, it's very true. So I would feel like, compared to any other careers, maybe lawyers, doctors, there's one path, there's one way, but in science, you could do pretty much whatever you want.